Hey folks, MysteriousJG here, and welcome back to Let's Play Mass Effect Andromeda. No longer Mass Effect Codex, as we're actually done reading the Codex for right now. For the journal, we got a lot of little quests that we could be doing, should be doing. Speaking with Addison on the Nexus, we got us going with a new priority op. A better beginning, we need to speak with Tan at the Nexus and give EOS Radiation a time to clear. We could try to start getting into Ryder family secrets. We can keep searching for memory blocks. We can find leads on the different arcs. I'd actually love to do that. I kind of am wondering what happened with those. I feel like that might start to expand our knowledge of interesting stuff that's going on in the universe. We probably could start doing the first murder one now, but I don't think that's time sensitive. And we do want to pick up the Pijack, because that's a thing. Scan wildlife. Locate the researcher other stations. Collect area resources and craft a weapon. I think we actually could do the Lost Brother pendant one, but I don't know what that's actually going to do for us. Meet Carrie. Scan minerals. I feel like some of these are the kinds of things that you would just bust out a FAQ and figure out how to do when you have to collect and spread all over the freaking place. Or maybe if it's they have to be located in those huge remnant vaults. This is part of our long-term thing where we're traveling to different planets. I wouldn't mind finding the colonist bodies once, but I don't know if we're actually given leads on the map for where to go for those. I sure hope we start getting some new missions to send these guys on, though. Because these guys are going to be done by the time this video is over. Oh, is this a, these are Apex missions, so I think we get to repeat them. Enemies everywhere! Well, we talked to you, but we haven't talked to anybody else who's new. So I guess we gotta go try to flirt with people and... We got our, Krogan who's like, oh, I'm a veteran, you know, because everyone talks about it. I'm not trying to insult veterans, I'm trying to insult this idea that he's the grizzled war veteran.
Report from the Nexus. Population's growing as people wake up. Lots of hopefuls waiting for a home.
Bradley,
yes, delightful. She's pretty excited about how we're not sucking.
Can't tell if they have enough water or too much.
But I know it's not the right amount.
I grew up on a little cargo freighter. Only saw gardens in vids, but I always loved them.
Well, you
I daydreamed about planting a big rose garden when we got here, and still imagine it sometimes. Roses in Helios.
Oh, you're a little softy.
So there's a heart soft as rose petals under that uniform.
I got plenty under here, pal. Does the big bad Pathfinder have a soft spot too?
I got lots under this shirt.
For certain someones.
Good to know. We've all got our something.
Me, it's roses. I'm a rose girl.
I didn't for a while. After I left the Asari Commandos, I didn't leave. My mentor, Nasira, said I should go.
She said I was really bad at commandoing.
The initiative would suit you better, was all she said. Being a huntress suited me fine, but she insisted.
Does seem kind of cold, actually. Maybe she was right. I don't know what to choose here. Should we go for rounded squigglies or squared squigglies? It's a tough call.
Wow. You fight side by side, and then she gives you the brush off?
It hurt. One big kick out of the nest. Still, that's familiar. When your biotics are honed into huntress-grade weapons, people can be weird about it.
No kidding.
The initiative seemed better. Just didn't see how I'd fit into their brave new galaxy. I never fit anywhere before. Then I
Well, that's like the archetype or reason that you need to be part of this.
Talked about traveling to Andromeda like he was teaching you how to see it.
What part of that vision made you want to take the plunge?
A civilization where everyone had a place. Even AI.
A civilization where apes evolved from men?
Your father said, I get being different. Now imagine being welcome and making others like you welcome too. When I was 13, I could warp a steel girder. He made me wonder, what if someone had told me that's okay?
Yeah, my dad was a great guy. You want to have sex with his son?
He gave you a dream to work toward. He was good at that.
Yeah,
who doesn't
want to dreams
belong,
of
especially
not
somewhere
being
like
a
the initiative? So I gave the initiative my all. Kept thinking of the niche I wanted, my rose garden. I thought I knew.
That's actually kind of sweet.
This is about not taking over as Pathfinder.
Didn't think it would still sting. Nasira, your father, even my parents. They leave, I'm left without answers. Nowhere to stand.
I think that's better than none of this is fair. I mean, I can't tell just how cold he's going to be about it when you select this option.
It sucks, but it happened. We need your mind on the mission.
Always is. But I'm human, too. Need time to find a way through.
Need my roses
and
shit.
And if that remnant tech pays off, maybe someday I'll have roses, too.
And if that nightingale won't sing, Mama's gonna buy you a remnant tech. Anything else to say to her? Oh.
Back again?
Thought we were done. Oh, the Asari Ark.
How's the search for the Asari Ark going?
The Lucinia? Checking every comm that's coming in. Nothing concrete yet.
See you later, Cora.
I'll be here.
I'll be waiting in all the old familiar places. Wait, what the heck was this picture? Oh, it's a dude. Time for the dude to get busy on you. Alright. Looks like this is taking us back towards. Oh, okay.
Those remnant vaults, all those secrets. I have to go exploding in one someday.
Imagine flying through one. Now that would be a real hazard course.
Get off your lazy ass and use your feet to walk, super Colo.
Hello, Gil. When are you cleaning up that repair on the sensor console?
Never. No, it's a redesign.
A redesign? Without a trained crew?
I'm trained and it's working great. Don't be so uptight.
Everything okay?
Oh. Fine. Fine. Don't worry about it.
I just hate him so much.
What can
hate,
I do for you?
Hate.
I couldn't help overhearing you and Gil.
Yeah, well, try
sounded
harder.
Pretty heated.
Next time, don't
he likes
here.
Redesigning things, but the ship was built this way for a reason. I wish Gil would respect that. It's nothing
respect
to concern yourself about, really.
It's not like it's going to build into a long-term plot arc.
What do you think of the rest of the crew?
Well, I can't talk about Suvi. She's sitting right there.
I'm not listening. You can say whatever you like.
Oh, no. I'm not falling for that again.
Apparently he fell for that once. I can't pee with Suvi right there.
I'll let you concentrate.
You know where I'll be.
I've never left this chair in my entire life. Not looking
down
your chest.
Scans of the Scourge.
Not at all.
All that dark energy twisting and turning on itself. It's splendid.
Oh, you like some kind of crazy goth chick, or?
I suppose it is a rather darkly beautiful phenomenon.
Darkly beautiful. I like that. Helios
like that enough
is
not
incredible,
to be such
isn't it? Not just constructs like the Scourge and the Remnant Vaults. Just all of it. So alien. A constant reminder of the divine intelligence behind all creation.
Oh god, you're this game's Ashley, aren't you?
You mean a god?
Yes, I believe in a higher power. I know it's a little odd, but I am a scientist because science brings me closer to something greater than myself.
Like climate change denial. Sorry. I feel the same way. There's no higher power. I kind of feel like you should have the option of, like, not jumping in and choosing a side. Although, I suppose if somebody tells you that you're religious and you start getting really, really evasive about it, you've pretty much given away that you're not. But, I think we can be like, you know, tell you what, you can choose to think what you want to think about me, but if somebody else is talking about religion, I'm not going to go all, like, in your face, Dave Foley, Ricky Gervais, Penn Jillette atheist on them. Even if you are not religious, you can kind of, like, yeah, maybe there's something out there. I don't know. That's okay.
There's something about coming face to face with something wondrous that makes you want to believe.
Even wow. If you know it's stupid.
It's wonderful to meet someone who understands. I've had to justify myself so often.
Yeah, I would think you wouldn't put it out there with people you just met in that case.
Validated my work as a scientist. As if the sacred could be diminished by the search for truth.
I like a diverse team. Now keep your weird shit to yourself.
It's good to have different voices on my team. I like that.
Even if I can't tell if they're Irish or Scottish.
The team, I should update the folks back in the Nexus with the latest reports. We'll talk later.
Not if I can help it. Not unless I can come up with a concrete in-game benefit for doing so.
I saw pictures of the vault. Astounding how big it is.
Oh, thanks.
And
oh, you're talking about the vault.
How much of it didn't you see? What if it's way bigger? What's all that space for?
Parties! I mean, that's just the stupidest thing ever.
With what it has to do, it could go thousands of miles below the surface of the planet.
Or completely span it. An underground network. Just a thought, of course. I wouldn't even know where to start hypothesizing how it all works.
Yeah,
the remnant
like,
builders, whoever,
could be a god machine to build Jesus's.
Accomplished something far beyond us.
Andromeda scans, your faith, terraforming.
What do you know about the remnant's terraforming network?
Was it
From
built
what
by Saren?
Tell, the vault is designed to adjust almost everything about a planet. Climate, pH of the soil, atmosphere composition. There's even evidence that it can propagate life. If we can figure out how to control the vaults, we could turn these worlds into perfect habitats.
I'm gonna hate myself for it, but I want to hear all the dialogue. Let's talk about our faith.
When did you start believing in a god?
My parents were both scientists. My home was ruled by rationality. So when I became a teenager...
Oh, it was your rebellious
Let's
thing.
Just say that while other kids found Batarian music, I found God.
But your work as a scientist...
Invalidates your
even
religion.
More, especially when I got into molecular biology, physics. The patterns I kept seeing over and over again, they were like an artist's watermarks. God, to me, is an artist. An inventor. Not someone checking to see if I brush my teeth.
I should get back to things.
Sounds good.
I still think that she's not from she's not Scottish or like you know from Southern Ireland. She's actually from Northern Ireland. She's from Ulster. So it's like the halfway point, Scottish Presbyterian descent, and he's just opening up this political firestorm for no reason. And that's why when you're like, where did you discover religion? She's like, I was never religious until the IRA blew up the pub where my brother was drinking. And then I joined the Loyalist Volunteer Force. No, they'd stop, JD. Besides, if she wouldn't sound like that. She would sound like Jerry Adams. I don't know. I don't have like a Northern Irish accent for women, but I can like do an impression of Jerry Adams.
When you asked me about my faith, Pathfinder... You must respect my right to feel differently from you.
Not that, I just got done like saying that, oh, she's like Ulster Protestant, and Jerry Adams being, of course, not Ulster Protestant, and kind of not loved by Ulster Protestants. Heartfelt thanks. Because I just decided to go into that for some reason. Heartfelt thanks to Dr. Ryder from Dr. Ariana. Family's my last expedition. Thank you for finding their loved ones. I hope your excursion has a happier ending. Does that mean we're done? We failed that quest because we got this far without finding all of them, or can we keep finding them? As for assistance, via the intrusion, I have an issue that you and Sam should be able to readily solve. It may assist my investigations into the Scourge. We can discuss in person at Nexus Lab. So we've got some more quest stuff. That vault. Why would Cora be sending us an email? We just talked to her. Can still smell that remnant vault on my arm. The seven deities! Lots of weird shit down there. Yes. Like my Huntress manuals would say. Delete, delete. The razor's edge between... No, teaches you what can be cut away. Now I think back, it might be a little bit of the temples on the Thetia. Same huge spaces and running, quote, water makes sense of a huge purpose you can't really understand. Makes me wonder if we'll ever really know what their builders did there. Here's... Oh, that's from Cora. This one's from Super Colo. Please report the Tempest is operating at peak efficiency. So now that you're in command, I thought I'd share a few secret shipboard hacks that are designated designers and I sneaked into her code. Just send the code JCSB through your arm tool to open the debug command menu. Give all dispense lets you use the coffee dispenser in the gallery an unlimited number of times. Water temp overdrive overrides the normal hot water ration in the showers. Jump wash queue puts your clothing ahead of everyone else's in the auto laundry cycle. Enjoy and don't share them around. That's very silly. Spirituality from Sue. I literally just got, like, as I'm talking to her, she's composing an email. I'm so glad for our chat earlier. I've had to defend what I believe so often, and I have to admit, I'm a little tired of it. Whenever I meet someone who feels the same or just understands, I really appreciate it. So thank you. Still not fucking you. Love, Suvi. About your dad, from Drac.
Bet you told me what happened to your dad. I've lost a few people over the years. Figured you could use some cheering up or at least distraction. This usually helps me.
Drac's attached 37 images of various rifles and shotguns. 2 are duplicate images. Many are low reds or watermarks.
Drac.
Oh, my name is Drac. Attachment, Krogan... Oh, from Lexi. Attachment, Krogan virility and aggression. Writer. Attaches my Krogan thesis that I mentioned to you. I know, only 500 pages, but I wasn't allowed to go over. If you get through it, I wrote a longer dissertation for the Citadel Journal of Medicine, around 1,400 pages. It's much more insightful and includes mating diagrams. These are all zany, of course. Yoga poses. Given the amount of high-impact cardio in your exercise routine, I recommend 5-10 minutes a day stretching to open your hips and relieve tightness in the lower back. Poses I've listed below should do nicely. Oh, my... Didn't mean to skip past, although I probably should have. Not to sound elitist, but while it's true humans invented yoga, the Asari perfected it. And then... There's actual yoga poses here. Please let me know if you need diagrams or vids. Data cores from BB. Hey, Ryder. Hope it's okay that I'm keeping the data core in my room. I eat the escape pod. I guess I just really like to ponder things before bed. Also, I saw it first. Anyway, blah, 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 blah. So we've got a new quote, our new quest. I guess we need to try to finish a better beginning. I don't think any of our current quests will lock down if we don't. Like his mom or something?
Don't give the Pathfinder too much trouble. Oh, Roshan. Kesh, Nexus Superintendent, thinks she can boss me around just because she's my granddaughter.
Oh, man, they're really going to push this. He's a grizzled old guy thing, even though there's... He's not... I don't know, it just doesn't... It doesn't feel right at all. Like, it... I don't know what the voice actor could be doing differently, what in the character design. He doesn't seem as old as this character is supposed to be his granddaughter. We like trouble here. No trouble is ideal. Yeah, trouble can be fun.
Well, welcome to the Tempest. Trouble's what we do.
I like the way you think, kid.
Someone somewhere shivered when I said that.
Probably Tam. Damn politicians.
Is that all you brought?
You travel lean when supplies are tight and you're on your own.
It's hard to be on your own. The Nexus has supplies.
Your people had to know what it'd be like when you left the Nexus.
We did, but there weren't a lot of options. After the mutiny happened, it was either buckle under Tan's rules or start our own colony. Easy choice. Bad consequences all around.
What about the Kesh? You killed one of them and made a big deal about it, or...?
Not all Krogan left. Your granddaughter stayed.
Good thing she did. Without my Rushan, you wouldn't have had much of a station to tie your ship to. As for me, I'm way more useful out here. Lots to shoot at, for one.
I understand why you left, or the Nexus needs you. Ugh. I feel like we gradually need to earn our way towards getting the Krogan back with the Nexus, and showing them a little sympathy up front is a good idea. I don't know if this decision will affect that as an overarching story path, or just our relationship with the Drac. But yeah, I would be thinking, yeah, we kind of do want to get these parties all back together and pulling in the same direction, but coming right out of the box and saying that is probably the best way to isolate him.
Your people come first.
Keeping Kesh and our colony safe will always be my top priority. That's why I'm happy to tag along, help make this galaxy a little more hospitable.
Can't argue with that.
Anyways, I mean, now we have more info in the freaking codex.
Ryder, you meet Spender yet? Colonial Affairs, the ass in Assistant Director. Got no idea why Addison keeps him around.
Spender
lied to Addison. Krogan during the uprising, and he's headed out for Kesh ever since. He's up to something. I just can't prove it. We should pay him a visit on the Nexus.
I guess exciting war stories might help fill in the deal with this guy, but it's Kesh.
What's it like to have Kesh as a granddaughter?
Kesh is my Rushan, child of my blood. Raised her myself.
She's not the same as Kat, so stop getting confused.
She did good, even with me for a granddad.
I like her. Take your word for it. I don't know why you'd say that.
She's honest. Definitely blunt.
She had to take after me in some ways, I guess.
Got any stories or advice to share?
Does a pie jack scratch its butt?
So you can just ignore that.
Anything about the cat or combat in general?
Well, common cat are pretty straightforward. Hit them hard enough, they die like anything else.
Tell me more about fighting cat.
Wraiths are sneaky little shits, like to ghost up behind you when you least expect it. Just listen for them. They tend to give themselves away right before coming at you.
They just get so
break through their head plates, then a headshot should do the trick.
What about Drac? I don't even remember what that is. Is that you? Oh, that's you. Yes, okay.
I'd like to know more about you.
Fire away.
Hit me with your best shot.
Tell me more about the Krogan colony.
You just
my
asked about me.
There. We also got some scouts looking for any unclaimed territory to grab up. Got a decent setup going. Self-sustainable. The works. Even some farming.
Farming? Krogan farm?
Food's food. Just because we can eat anything doesn't mean we gotta settle for scraps. I'm pretty fond of Corkrow roots myself. Takes a while to chew through those.
Why would you be surprised Krogan farm? I mean, how the hell do you think they... I suppose it's possible they could be purely meat-eaters, but...
So, about all this combat experience you have, I'd love some
details. Sounds like bullshit to me.
The list will be shorter if you ask me what experience I don't have.
Alright, tell me what you don't
have. I've
been
doing this for a long time now. Centuries. Shit, well over 1,000 years. Don't even know how I'm still alive, to be honest.
Yeah, neither do I.
Skill?
You need luck to be a merc. Skill, sure, but a whole lot of luck. Hard head.
You need a whole lot of luck. I need a whole lot of luck. Sorry.
How did you and Vetra meet?
Huh, that's right. Your father brought you into the project pretty late, didn't he? Must
have
been a pretty steep learning curve since they sawed you out.
You could say that.
You make do with what you get. Anyway, I met Vetra back when we were building the Nexus. She swiped supplies I was trying to get for Kesh right under my nose. I tried to intimidate her into turning them over to me, and let me tell you, that Turian takes shit from no one.
She's pretty awesome that way.
She really has a way of getting things done.
She sure does. But here's the best part. She waited until I saw her again in Kesh's office, no less, to tell me she'd been working for Kesh all along.
That was
They're
a lie.
They're both still laughing at me over that.
Did Lexi brief you on Sam and squad connectivity yet?
Yeah. You want to hook that thing up to my comms, sure, but that's where it stops. Putting an AI in your head, giving it access to everything like that, it's begging for trouble.
To go back a moment, she was working for my granddaughter all along, they sure laughed at me, ha ha ha. That's a pretty cheap storytelling tool, because they basically set up that this woman was stealing from his family, and he was impressed by how ballsy that is. But then he's not a wuss for having not freaking broken her face for stealing from his family. So it's like, he's a grizzled veteran, he's got a soft spot for this, you know, whatever. But they gave him like a cheap out for why he's still a grizzled veteran and badass combat guy, even though he didn't fucking murder this person for stealing.
Why do you say that?
What's wrong with having AI take over your brain? When they turn on their creators. Been in some of those fights. There's a reason that kind of research was outlawed.
Yeah. I was dismissed from the Alliance when news of what my dad was researching got out.
No shit. Ruined the writer name, I'll bet.
Almost. I'm not thrilled about it myself, but it is what it is.
Oh, I didn't mean to say it that way.
Just make sure it can't unshackle itself. There'll be hell to pay if that happens.
Yeah, I didn't actually mean to say that about Sam.
Did Lexi brief you on Sam and Squad?
Yeah. Putting an AI in your head, giving it access to everything like that, it's begging for trouble.
I don't really have the option of backing out. I didn't mean to slam Sam.
Why did the Krogan leave the Nexus?
The Nexus got us Krogan to stop the mutiny. In return, we were supposed to get a say in station business. Spender, Addison's assistant, lied about the deal, and Tan came down hard. Too hard. So we left. Kesh is alone on that station now.
How is she with politics? You were worried about her.
You think someone might try to hurt Kesh?
More like she airlocks Spender. Or he tries to stab her in the back, and then she airlocks him. Tan wouldn't listen to me when I told him Spender had a part in the mutiny. I had no proof.
So what's my part in this?
Things need to get sorted out, and my clan needs to get back on station, without Spender messing things up. Way I see it, you're probably the best one for that job.
We can talk more later.
Sure.
Hey, one last thing.
Yeah?
Do you call everyone kid? Don't call me kid. I guess we'll try this. I might go back through and do it again and not say that about Sam.
I don't love being called kid.
I'll try to stop doing that. Can't promise I won't slip up, though.
Kid. It kicks you in the nuts. So if we give me a chance to save. So yeah, I figured we got a new quest to prove that one dude is an evil asshole. Spencer or whatever his name is. Addison. But I'm wondering if we go back and load. That's at 130. Okay, we got an autosave probably right before we talk to him. Because I kind of didn't mean to. I don't know what I thought he was going to say, but I didn't think he was going to say, like, yeah, I'm really upset that Sam is in my head, because I think we have to kind of try to be nice with Sam.
I've seen a lot of shit in my life, but that vault certainly was a first. Things are gonna be interesting with you around, kid.
Doesn't matter what life throws at me. Also, don't call me kid.
Oops.
So I guess that was not an early enough autosave.
Sure.
He's just gonna keep calling his kid, isn't he? This might be too early. This might not be worth going back and redoing a bunch of conversations for, but I'm curious. We're pretty much at the end of the video anyway, so I might just go through it again and not say that about Sam, and then rather than say, don't call me kid, since he's just going to keep doing it anyway, just ask if he calls everyone kid. Because I probably wouldn't want to start a big conversation with the Krogan over that, especially if he is over 1,000 years old. He just wants to call, you kid, you probably just got to let that go.
Ryder, you meet Spender yet? Colonial Affairs, the ass in Apt. Got no idea why Apt. Spender lied to the Krogan. He's up to something. I just can't prove it. We should pay him a visit on the Nexus.
Did Lexi brief you on Sam and Squad?
Yeah. You want to hook that thing up to putting an AI in your head, giving it access to everything like that. It's begging for trouble.
Why do you say that?
I've seen... been in some of those fights.
Yeah. I was dismissed from the Alliance when...
No shit.
Almost.
But fuck you, I love Sam, he's my best buddy.
Sam is part of what makes someone a Pathfinder. You're just gonna have to deal with that.
So long as it's not in my head and it ain't messing with my body.
Alright, that works, actually.
Why did the Krogan leave the Nexus?
Spender.
I guess I gotta go through all this, I gotta go through all this again in order to get the last little bit of dialogue, so we'll skip this as fast as we can.
Well, I see it, you're probably the best one for that job.
I'd like to know more about you.
Fire away.
So about
your best shot.
Don't even know.
Skill?
You need luck to be a merc and a really hard head.
So, about all this combat experience you have.
I've been doing this for a long...
Skill?
And a really hard head.
But there's something you could ask about the fighting the cat, wasn't there?
Huh.
You could say that.
You make do... She swipes a... I tried to intimidate her into turning them over to me, and let me tell you... They're both still laughing at me over that.
Tell me more about the Krogan
farming about Saren.
Food's food. I'm pretty fond of Corkrow roots myself. Takes a while to chew through those.
Got any stories or advice to
Oh, I guess this was
the Jack scratch its butt.
This is the one where you
well,
find out about
cat are pretty straightforward. Cat. Wraiths break through their head plates, then a headshot should do the trick.
What's it like to have Cash as a
damn proud of her too. She did good. Even with me for a granddad.
She's honest. Definitely.
She had to take after me in some ways, I guess.
We can talk more later.
Sure.
Hey, sure, one last thing.
I mean,
yeah?
Ryder. Do you call everyone kid?
Is everyone a kid to you?
Ha, when you get to be my age, yeah, pretty much.
I think I kind of prefer the outcome where you tell him not to call you kid. So as ludicrous as this sounds, I'm going to go through that dialogue one more time off screen. Tell him not to call me kid. Just so that he'll have the humor of his continuing to call us kid anyway. And also doing the outcome of the conversation about Sam the way that we did there. So yeah. We'll come out with a slightly different version. I'll do that off screen. When we come back, I would imagine we've got to talk to everybody on the ship. And then next stop, I guess we're going to go to the Nexus and try to advance some of these main story threads. I'd like to get Eos to where it becomes open world and we can start doing the side quests proper. And I'm sure that eventually there will be other planets that become available to us, so... things are starting to open up, and we can... I think we've hit the point where we can take things in somewhat different directions, but we'll see, folks. We'll see. I'm MysteriousJG.